15. Welcome students in class 10. First chapter for class 10 bio is life processes. First, we have to decide how can we identify that anything is alive. You must have learned different topics from class 5 to class 9, which all are assembled here and little bit explored also. So the first topic what I am going to discuss, that is how can we understand that anything is alive. Characteristics of living things you must have learned earlier. All living things have movement without any external force. Living things have growth, development. Living things have certain life processes also. They are performing certain life processes also. They need food and water. They reproduce, they excrete, etc. So the most important criteria to decide whether something is alive is movement. Movement of body parts and movement of particles inside the body, in the cells as well as in the tissue. So what is the meaning of life processes? All those biological activities which happen inside the body are commonly known as life processes. Whether a living being is unicellular or multicellular. So life processes are the basic processes in living organisms which are necessary for sustenance of life, maintenance of life. The basic life processes are nutrition, respiration, transportation, excretion. In this chapter, we will study about these life processes one by one. So, the first we will try to understand different terminology, that is nutrition, respiration, transportation and excretion. You must have learned nutrition in class 7. Nutrition is the process of taking food by an organism and its proper utilization for growth and maintenance of the body for different life processes. Likewise, respiration is the process by which food is burnt in the cells of the body with the help of oxygen to release energy. In simple language, you can understand that respiration is a process by which food particle is utilized inside the cell to produce energy. And why do we need energy? For growth and development, for running the different life processes. Transportation is the process by which food, oxygen, water, waste products are carried from one part of the body to the other. You must aware with the word transport. In lower classes you must have learned means of transport. So here also transportation means carrying anything. So how can food, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water and other waste products are carried from one part of the body, one organ of the body to the different part, that is known as transportation. Now excretion. Excretion is the process by which waste products which are synthesized inside the body, inside a living body, are removed from the body. You are aware with the excretion little bit. You have learned these systems in class 6, excretory system, in which urine is formed. You have learned earlier, sweat, one excretory product, carbon dioxide, another excretory product, and so on. Now, one by one, we will discuss all these topics in detail. Nutrition is the process of taking food by an organism and the utilization by the body to build the body, for growth, to repair the damaged parts of the body, for getting energy, etc. Here you can observe the diagrams of human digestive system, human breathing system, transportation process with the help of heart as well as the vessels and urinary system. How blood, where blood is filtered inside the kidney and how urine is formed. Diagrams are given here. You may understand by observing it properly. Now about the nutrition. Nutrition, earlier I told, it is the process by which food is taken by an organism and it is utilized by the body to build the body for growth and maintenance and to keep it disease free, healthy, fit and fine, as well for getting energy for the body. Life on earth depends on carbon based molecules, and most of the food are also carbon based molecules. The outside raw materials used by living organisms are food, water and air. You must have learned the term nutrients in early classes. Nutrients are chemicals present in different foodstuffs, which are basically carbon hydrogen compounds, and in higher organism, in higher animals, these are digested with the help of digestive enzymes and are changed into the simpler substances so that body can utilize. So only three raw materials a living organism get in from the external environment, that is food, water and air. You must have learned in lower class, living things breathe, so getting air from which oxygen is utilized. Living things need food and water, you have learned. Now, different modes of nutrition. This topic also you have learned in class 7. Again, we are repeating, so you have some knowledge about it. Memorize that. Modes of nutrition, because two different types of living beings are present in the nature. One, which have chlorophyll pigments in them, that is basically green plants, and the other group of living being which have no chlorophyll pigments, that is non-green plants as well as the animals. So there are two different modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. The living being which have chlorophyll pigments in them, they have autotrophic nutrition, and those which do not have chlorophyll pigments in them have heterotrophic nutrition. Auto means apne aap and trops mean food, banana. So autotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which organisms prepare their own food from simple inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. It is better to speak here light, because you must have seen many of the plants kept inside the room and they are growing. So sunlight as well light also. For example, all green plants and some bacteria. Now the second type, heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic is nutrition in which organisms get their food directly or indirectly from green plants. So all living, all animals and the non-green plant, that is fungi and some bacteria. Now the types of heterotrophic nutrition. You are observing different types of animals in nature, as well non-green plants are also there. So there are mainly three different types of heterotrophic nutrition. These are saprotrophic nutrition, parasitic nutrition and holozoic nutrition. Saprotrophic or saprophytic, both have same meaning. Saprophytic nutrition. It is the mode of nutrition in which organisms get their food from dead and decaying organisms. They break down the food materials outside their body and then absorb it. This is one of the example of exodigestion. There are two types of living being. One group has exodigestion, means digestion process happens outside the body and that digested form is taken by the body. That is exodigestion. So here digestive enzymes are secreted over the dead and decaying matter outside of the body and they are broken into simpler form, and then those food materials are absorbed by the saprophytic organisms. For example, mushroom, bread mold, yeast and some bacteria. You must have seen mushroom growing over the cordon kept for many days. Over bread, molds are growing. Over pickles, you must have seen sometimes. Over some vegetables also, during rainy season, you must have seen some wave-like structure, that is mold, yeast. You are well familiar. In class 8 in microorganism chapter, you have learned about the yeast. Yeast is a useful, friendly fungi which helps in the fermentation and some other bacteria also. Now the second type, that is parasitic nutrition. It is nutrition process in which organisms get their food from other living organism, which is called host here, without killing them. In such type of nutrition, one organism is benefited and other is not benefited, even other has some problem too. That's why it is known as parasitic nutrition. You must have seen some insects sitting over the cows, lice in the hair of human being, leeches, roundworm, tapeworm, these are growing inside the human body, intestine, malarial parasite, that is plasmodium. These all are parasitic nutrition. Some plants are also parasitic, dodder, cascuta, these are. You have learned in class 7. Orchid, etc. So, on which plant orchid is growing? That plant is named as host plant and orchid is parasitic. Likewise, lice is parasite, is a parasite, and human being is a host. Human blood, from human blood, lice is getting its food material and it is beneficial for him, for it as well. It is harmful for the human being. Now about the third type, holozoic nutrition. It is nutrition process in which organism take food directly and then digest and absorb it. In every day of our life, we are seeing the different foodstuffs we are taking in. But the foodstuffs are, the nutrients are here in complex form and body is not able to absorb them as it is. So it is very necessary to digest them to make them into simpler form, soluble form, so that body can absorb. That's why digestion takes place inside the body and it is endodigestion. For example, amoeba, paramecium, birds, fishes, human beings, many of the organisms you are observing. Here also diagrams are given to show different type of heterotrophic nutrition. Mushroom, saprotrophic nutrition. Dodder is given here. Those yellow thread-like structures are dodder growing over the another green plant. Parasitic in nature. And amoeba, it has holozoic nutrition. Ours also, holozoic nutrition. Now nutrition in plants. In detail, we are going to learn in detail about the autotrophic nutrition. Photosynthesis. From class 5, 6 only, you are familiar with the word photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process by which plants prepare food by using carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. The food prepared is carbohydrate, that is glucose, which is stored in the form of starch inside the plant body. As well, oxygen is also formed as the byproduct and released to the atmosphere. That's why green plants are also known as air purifier. You must have learned earlier. Now the equation of photosynthesis is, I think you are knowing to balance the equation. 6CO2 plus 12H2O in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. C6H12O6, it is glucose molecule, plus 6H2O plus 6O2. Consumption of 12H2O means 12 molecules of water and 6 molecules of carbon dioxide in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. 1 molecule of glucose is formed, whereas 6 molecules of water in the form of water vapor and 6 molecule of oxygen is formed. Process of photosynthesis. As you have learned in chemistry, the components which are written in the left side of the arrow, these are reactants. So carbon dioxide and water written in left side are reactants. Right side. And the products which are written left side are products. Photosynthesis takes place in three main steps. The first step is absorption of light energy by chlorophyll pigments. That's why chlorophyll pigments are also known as site for the process of photosynthesis. Very simple example I am giving to the students. that if we want to make tea in the kitchen, we must need a container to prepare the tea. So, as the container, chlorophyll pigments are acting here. Now, conversion of light energy into chemical energy and splitting up of water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen. Light energy is also absorbed by the chlorophyll, is utilized to split the water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen. So here light energy acts as the fuel. Now reduction of carbon dioxide by hydrogen to form carbohydrate. Oxygen and hydrogen, which are formed earlier by splitting of water molecules, react with carbon dioxide molecule to form glucose molecule as well as oxygen molecules, and some amount of water vapor, water is, some molecules of water also formed. Diagram you may observe on the screen. One green plant is given here. Solar energy is absorbed by the green plant. Carbon dioxide is taken from the atmosphere and oxygen is released to the atmosphere, and roots are absorbing water and glucose molecules are formed in the leaves. Here I must want to say that if the plants are terrestrial, so this example is, this diagram is applicable. But if the plant is aquatic, an aquatic plant, then they get carbon dioxide from the water body and they release oxygen molecule into the water body. And water is present there and solar energy is available because water is a transparent medium. Now about the chlorophyll pigments. Chlorophylls are the green pigments present in the leaves. If we observe a cross section of a leaf under a microscope, we can see cells containing green dots, the structure called chloroplast. In class 9, you must have studied in the chapter cell about the plastid. Green colored plastids are known as chloroplast. Due to presence of chlorophylls, they are named so. And diagram is given here inside the cell also, how these are present and how in the leaf these are present. Diagrams are available on the screen and you may study them from there. Stomata. Stomata are the specialized tissue cells. You must have learned in class 9 in tissue chapter. Stomata are the tiny pores surrounded by the guard cells. So specialized tissue guard cells are, these are tiny pores present in the leaves through which exchange of gases takes place. Means when the plant body requires oxygen, they get in oxygen through the stomata, and after respiration carbon dioxide is formed, that comes out through the stomata at night only. But during the day, stomata gets carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and forms oxygen inside the plant body. Each stoma has a pair of guard cells. The green part, whatever seen on the screen, are guard cells, and the white part is one individual stoma. Guard cell control the opening and closing of stomatal pore. When water absorbed enters the guard cell swells and the pores open. And when the guard cells lose water, it shrinks and the pores closes. Both the diagrams are given here. You are able to observe it on the screen. Now, activity to show that chlorophylls are necessary for photosynthesis. Take a potted plant having variegated leaves, means shaded differently, somewhere green, somewhere yellow or white, etc., croton plant, and keep it in a dark room for 3 days. Why is it so? So that whatever glucose molecules are prepared earlier, that can be consumed by the plant. All the starch is used up. Then keep it in sunlight for 6 hours. Then take a leaf from the plant and mark the green areas of the leaf on a sheet of paper. The same diagrams you have to make on a sheet of paper. Then dip the leaf in boiling water to make it soft. Then dip the leaf in alcohol and heat it in a water bath to decolorize it and remove the chlorophyll. Then wash the leaf in water and dip it in dilute iodine solution. It will be seen that only the green parts of the leaf turns blue-black. This shows that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. Firstly, we have kept questions from such type of activities are coming. Why the plant is kept in the dark for 3 days so that starch can be consumed by the plant? Why it is boiled in alcohol so that iodine can act well? And why while boiling it is kept over the water bath? Because alcohol is highly inflammable, and then iodine is added because iodine turns starch blue-black, color is changed. So the part where green color present in the leaf, that only turns blue-black. So what does it show? It shows that only green colored part of the plant body is able to do photosynthesis. Means chlorophyll pigments are necessary for photosynthesis. Now the second activity to understand that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. Take 2 potted plants of the same size and keep them in a dark room for 3 days. Again, now you can understand why the plants are kept in dark room, so that starch can be utilized. Then keep the plants on separate glass plates and keep a wash glass containing some potassium hydroxide near one plant to absorb carbon dioxide, and cover both the plant with bale jar. Plastics can also be, transparent plastics can also be used, but it should be airtight, and seal the bottom of the jar with Vaseline to make it airtight. Now see, earlier whatever starch were present in both the plant were utilized, and now they are kept under the sun, transparent either glass jar or transparent polythene can be utilized so that sunlight can reach to the plant, but both the plants are airtight. In one plant, with one plant, KOS, potassium hydroxide, is kept so that whatever extra carbon dioxide is present inside the bale jar, glass jar or the plastic, that should be absorbed by potassium hydroxide. But in another plant, with another plant, it was not kept. Now keep the plant in sunlight for 3 hours, then take a leaf for each plant and taste for starch, which we understood earlier. The leaf of the plant kept in the jar containing potassium hydroxide does not show the presence of starch. Why? because carbon dioxide was not present there. But another one turns blue-black because some amount of carbon dioxide was present with the air inside the glass jar or the polythene cover. This shows that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. Another one question is here, why potassium hydroxide is used to absorb the carbon dioxide present in air? Non-nutrition in animals. Nutrition in amoeba. Amoeba is a unicellular organism, belongs to group protozoa, and it is an aquatic animal. It takes in food by forming finger-like projection called pseudopodia. It has holozoic mode of nutrition and forms a food vacuole. Inside the food vacuole, the food is digested. Digestive juices are also present inside the cytoplasm of amoeba and then absorbed. The undigested food is then sent out through the surface of the cell. You can understand it through the diagram how food is taken in and how waste material is thrown out from the food vacuole. Now the next topic is nutrition in human beings, which we will study in second session. Okay, thank you.